All right, boys and girls, I've had such a great feedback about these potpourri videos where I just talk through a couple x-rays from the patients I've seen in the emergency department that I've created two more. This is potpourri number three, and stay tuned, we'll come up with potpourri number four. This one I did a little different. I hope you enjoy this format. It's a lot quicker to see the pictures and compare them too. First, let's look at this x-ray. It's an x-ray of the chest of a patient who's obviously had some cardiac surgery, has some sutures in the middle of the chest there with wires. We have the heart, which seems a little large, and there's an abnormality there that is very prominent. Remember, when we order x-rays from the ER, it's because they're short of breath, they're having chest pain, having palpitations, maybe they're fatigued, and the patient has multiple medical problems. So look at this x-ray, pause it, try to figure out what's wrong with it, and then unpause, and let's look at the next slide. Right there. So the heart itself is enlarged. It's more than 50% of the cardiothoracic size. So that's a cardiothoracic ratio, more than 50% is cardiomegaly, or an enlarged heart. The other thing you see right here is you follow that yellow line, that's the border of the heart on the left side of the heart, or left ventricle. And you can see the triangle, which is red, that's an area of density. That should look black, kind of like on the upper part of the lung, where it looks black, or on the other side of the lung, on the right side, where it looks uniform all the way through. So that area there is either fluid, pneumonia, atelectasis. In this particular case, the patient had a fever and a cough, so the diagnosis is pneumonia. Now let's look at it again, this time without the arrows and the lines. And you can notice right away that it looks abnormal. This is most likely a lingular infiltrate. Lingula is the middle lobe on the left side. On the right side, you have three lobes. Upper, lower, and middle lobe. On the left side, because the heart takes part of the lung space, that middle lobe becomes small, or it's called the lingula. And because the heart border gets obscured by this infiltration process or pneumonia, then it's called a lingular infiltrate. Let's look at the next one. This one, not much to think about. You can see there's something obvious there. But I wanted to share it with you because not always is it's clear and obvious like the previous x-ray. This right here was read by the radiologist as pneumonia, and the ER doctor who saw the x-ray first did not read it as pneumonia, mainly because we might have read it as hilum, a more pronounced hilum from inflammation, bronchiolitis, maybe viral process going on. In this particular case, it was read as pneumonia by the radiologist because we did not read it as such. We had to call the patient, put them on antibiotics, follow up, and things like that. But the main point of this slide is, you can notice some pneumonias are very evident, very clear. This particular pneumonia, not so much. So you have to be very careful and you have to look in detail at that lung tissue. Next slide. This is a foot x-ray, and you'll see the next x-ray to see exactly what's wrong. But look right in the middle of the foot. There's a density there. Do you see it? Let's look at the next one. On the lateral view, it's clear and obvious. It's a foreign body on the plantar side of the foot. The patient stepped on a piece of nail, or it could be a needle or something like that. And it's a foreign body that obviously needs to be removed because we want to avoid infection, things like that. This one's pretty superficial, but when they're very deep, sometimes we have to leave it in place and leave it for a podiatrist or orthopedic doctor, foot surgeon to go and dig it out because of damage to deeper structure, tendons and things like that. But this one's superficial, so we were able to remove it in the emergency department. This one right here is not necessarily something's wrong with it, but I wanted to share with you what some things look like on an x-ray. That right there, that is called a green field filter. This patient had a history of recurrent DVTs, deep vein thrombosis of the leg, and would show throw clots into his lung despite being on anticoagulation medicine. This is when we put patients on a green field filter. This is basically an umbrella with those legs. It's put on the vena cava, the main vein going into the liver, so that when that clot starts traveling up, it gets stopped and it doesn't get to the lungs where it can kill the patient. So this is a green field filter. Obviously, you can see there's some hardware on the bottom of the back from surgeries. Maybe that's why he developed clots in the first place, because usually surgeries cause that kind of problem. This was a patient who presented with knee pain, and the x-ray doesn't look bad at all. However, there's one important finding that increases your suspicion for something wrong. Let's find that finding first, and then we'll show you the actual problem. Make sure you pause this video, take your time to look at it in detail, and then let's move to the next slide. right there. That is an effusion of the knee joint. You can see the separation or shadow that occurs right here, showing that there's fluid in the joint space. And that's where the fracture is. Remember how it looked before? Look at it right now. That line right there is a tibial plateau fracture. And now this is the original x-ray. Now you can clearly see the shadow of the effusion increasing your suspicion there's a fracture, and then you find it on the medial plateau there of the knee. Now that patient definitely needs orthopedic referral and follow-up. Initial management in the ER, probably a knee mobilizer, crutches. Call an orthopedic doctor to see if it's something they want to emergently manage, but most of the time they see him in the office in a few days. This x-ray right here was an x-ray done for abdominal pain. Maybe the patient showed up with nausea and vomiting. We did an x-ray, and at that point we didn't know if it was constipation, bowel obstruction or what, so we performed an x-ray. And there's a very minuscule finding. Make sure you take the time to look at it in detail and then move forward to the next slide. There it is. The line in red is actually the kidney border, and the spot that's yellow, that's a kidney stone. Let's look at the x-ray again. Before, you couldn't really see it, could you? It's really minor, and that's a lot of the things in medicine. That's why we're good at it, because we're trained to look for these things, not because they're obvious at a first glance. So this is, now that you know what it looks like, it's in the right place where the kidney is, then you know what to look for in terms of kidney stones. So for this patient, if you weren't suspicious of kidney stones as a cause of the pain, now that you see that, you're likely, okay, maybe the pain is from a kidney stone. This one right here was an x-ray of the hand done because the patient had a swollen hand, no trauma. So usually we don't do an x-ray per se, because if it's atraumatic, something else, probably infectious or cellulitis or something like that. However, we did an x-ray. And then we did not read the finding that we're talking about here. And this is why I'm posting, because it wasn't really obvious to the emergency physicians. A well-trained radiologist who can find important things much better than we can. But now that you're looking at this video, you'll be able to find it out if you ever see it. So this is what it was read as. Three views of the right hand were obtained. There's soft tissue swelling of the right hand, no fractures or dislocations. These findings may represent cellulitis, so soft tissue swelling, maybe cellulitis. There's an 8 millimeter loosened benign appearing lesion in the first metacarpal bone, which may represent an endochondroma. And if there's pain on that side, they're recommending an MRI, because it could be tumorous or cancerous or something like that, but most likely a benign lesion. Now let's look at it again. You see the yellow spot? Now let's look at it again. Now you can see, this is the original x-ray, this was the missed finding, and right there, an endochondroma. And that's it for now. I hope you enjoyed this potpourri video. I will be posting a fourth video soon, so stay tuned. Bye-bye.